Hi, this is Kashpunisa Bagewari. Welcome to my channel. In this video, I am going to talk about AWS weekly release for the week of 2nd November 2020. So let's start. Introducing new visualization features in AWS IoT Sitewise, status charts, scatter plots, and trend line. AWS IoT Sitewise now supports AWS CloudFormation. Amazon Honeycode releases three new app templates that help team manage works. Amazon Kinesis Data Stream enables data stream retention up to 1 year. AWS Code Artifact now supports resource tagging. Amazon Bracket now supports resource tagging. Announcing AWS Private Link support for Amazon Bracket. EFA now supports NVIDIA GPU Direct RDMA. Amazon RDS Data API supports tag-based authorization. New AWS Solution Consulting offer and Trace Cloud Management. Announcing new Amazon EC2 P4D instances deployed in EC2 Ultra clusters for highest performance ML training and HPC application in the cloud. Amazon EC2 on-demand capacity reservation now supports AWS VLAN zones. Amazon EC2 auto-scaling, EC2 fleet and Spot fleet announce capacity rebalancing for EC2 Spot instances. Amazon CloudWatch launches Matrix Explorer. AWS Launch Wizard now supports single instance deployment of SQL Server or Windows and Linux. Amazon Elasticsearch service now supports defining a custom name for your domain endpoint. AWS Marketplace enables vendor-provided cost allocation tags, enhancing visibility into software costs for analysis, allocation, and optimization. AWS Security Hub adds 5 new integrations and new consulting partner. AWS Client VPN announces self-service portal to download VPN profiles and desktop applications. Introducing EC2 instance rebalance recommendation for EC2 Spot instances. Amazon RDS for SQL Server now supports database mail. Saving plan alert now available in AWS Cost Management. Announcing Amazon MQ for RabbitMQ. AWS Lambda now supports Amazon MQ for Apache ActiveMQ as an event source. Amazon Kendra adds Confluence Cloud Connector. Amazon EMR service limits can now be managed through AWS service quotas. AWS Fargate for Amazon ECS announces features focused on configuration and metrics. Introducing Document Understanding Solution. Amazon Connect has just reduced its 44th telephony rate this year. AWS System Manager Ops Center now integrates with Amazon CloudWatch for easier diagnosis and remediation of alarms. AWS System Manager Quick Setup now supports targeting a resource group. AWS Service Catalog now supports stack-based instance operations. Amazon Redshift announces open-source JDBC and Python drivers. AWS IoT SDK for embedded C version 2.0.2.0.11.0 now includes Refactor Core HTTP, AWS IoT Device Defender, and AWS IoT Job Libraries. AWS Client VPN now supports Client Connect Handler. Amazon GuardDuty now available in AWS GovCloud region. Amazon Transcribe now supports German, Italian, and two more AWS regions for streaming audio. Amazon SQS introduces new console experience in AWS GovCloud region. Amazon Kendra now available in Asia Pacific Sydney region. Amazon EBS Fast Snapshot Restore FSR is now available in AWS GovCloud region. Amazon Event Bridge is now available in AWS GovCloud region. That's it for this week. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.